A mouth-watering top-of-the-table clash in store tonight at the Aegeus Bowl as Hampshire host Kent Spitfires in the NatWest T20 Blast. Hampshire are able to bolster their already impressive batting ranks with a reintroduction of the big-hitting Australian Glenn Maxwell, recently back from the IPL. The Spitfires are looking to keep up their 100% winning record in this year's competition, and they're able to welcome back spinner James Treadwell from international duty. Home captain James Vince won the toss and opted to bat in gloriously sunny conditions, but the highest score in this year's 2020 Blast failed to ignite this time. But Jimmy Adams was feeling in a more explosive mood, and he took 14 off a Darren Stevens over to get the score to 37 from the first five overs. And Adams carried on his merry way with a magnificent switch hit which went all the way for six as Hampshire looked to accelerate through the middle overs. But young spinner Adam Riley had his revenge in the very next over, trapping Adams' leg before. That wicket brought Glenn the big show Maxwell to the crease, and he introduced himself to James Treadwell with a huge blow for six, only for the England spinner to have the last laugh the very next ball when Maxwell picked out the fielder in the deep to leave Hampshire 83 for three in the 11th. Michael Carberry batted sensibly at the other end and went to his half century in style with his full-blooded swing off the bat as Hampshire sailed into three figures. And by the end of the innings, Carberry was in full flow, this time an almighty pull off Doug Bollinger, adding late momentum. But Kent hit back with late wickets, Oa Shah and Sean Irvine going before Bollinger cleaned up Carberry with a full and straight delivery. Nonetheless, a very healthy total from Hampshire, making 171 for 7 from their 20 overs. Michael Carberry, 73, patched the innings together brilliantly. Doug Bollinger was the pick of the bowlers with 3 for 19 from his overs. A very interesting run chase should follow after the break, Kent requiring 172 for victory.